Hi everyone, it's me, Mr. Healed again. Happy Holy Thursday, Hoppy Easter. The bunny thing. Never gonna understand the bunny thing. But we are here, we are in the Triduum. This is the holiest piece of the Christian calendar. This is our Super Bowl. And we really have to pay acknowledgement to the people that we talked to about yesterday, the Jews, right? The Jewish holiday of Passover, which they are currently celebrating, and we still want to wish a happy holidays to every member of our community that celebrates the Passover, is instrumental in understanding what happens on Holy Thursday. Why? Okay, the first thing you have to understand is that Jesus is his group's rabbi, okay? So he's not just their friend, he's not just traveling them, he's also their rabbi. But also, he, during Holy Thursday, is celebrating a Passover Seder. Now, yesterday we said the Jews were saved in their most famous story through the blood of a young, perfect male. Now, it happened to be a lamb. In this story, we're going to see that it's Jesus' sacrifice as a young, perfect, never sinned male. Okay? So what happens on Holy Thursday? Let's read from the Gospel of Matthew. While they were eating, Jesus took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body." He took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them all, saying, "Drink from it, all of you. For this is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed on behalf of many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, from now I shall not drink this fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it with you new in the kingdom of my Father." That is only three sentences, but they are probably the most important three sentences in any of our lives, because Jesus is now fully telling us that our sins, the times that we told God no, are now going to be paid off. It doesn't mean we don't pay for our sins. It doesn't mean that we're not still responsible for our sins. What it means, though, is that we don't have to pay the price for our sins. We don't have to deal with the repercussions of our sins, because Jesus, by spilling his blood, by sharing his blood, just like the lamb, is going to shield us from eternal death. Jesus, by going on that cross, Jesus, by sharing with us his body and blood, is going to do two things. One, going on the cross, he is going to pay the ransom for our death. But two, Jesus gives us his body, and Jesus gives us his blood. That's God's body in God's blood. And he says, "Do this in memory of me." That means every single person in the world has the opportunity every single Sunday to become more holy. How? By going to Mass. Every Sunday, Catholics believe and know that the body of God exists in them, making them more perfect, and that the blood of God exists in them, making them more perfect. So Jesus not only paved the path to heaven for us by dying on the cross, but he also gave us the tools for perfection and holiness. That is the Eucharist and the precious blood. Have a wonderful day. Remember that you are loved at your school and you are loved by your God. And tomorrow we're going to see just how much that God loves you.